So I have the sense I cannot relax. I feel disbalanced. I know I do it, and I also heal. I know something is healing, and something is freaking out, like old beliefs I believe, and I cannot stop. And where I live, I go through a fear, and a little bit it changed, but I cannot rest there. I don't know where, what is it, what I do so wrong, or is there still so much to heal that it is okay like it is? So you have a lot. I don't know if you can help me.
For you to get through this, you need to understand yourself. Understanding yourself without having identification with yourself. Understanding yourself without even needing to view yourself as being yours. You're immersed in yourself. You need to see yourself for what it is, what kind of self you have, what caliber of self you have, what kind of level of self you have, what kind of maturity or lack of maturity there is in yourself. You need to be able to see all of that just for what it is, without having the emotional attachment, the emotional relating in yourself. All of the difficulties that you have in yourself are fair to what kind of self you have. All of your difficulties are understandable, given the kind of self you have. You can, as awareness, move past yourself, but not first without your being able to see yourself really for what it is.
So maybe like when I would be a mother and I look at my child as what it is.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
The difficulty you have with yourself is that you keep relating to yourself.
I understand I would like to not do it, and I don't know why I do it like this.
Because it is the self you have, and you're in that self. You're in that self all of the time. It is what you relate to. What you're not relating to is that you are, as awareness, more than what yourself is. You're not relating to what you really are, that has a self. That has a self that you're able to move past.
Move past means?
To be more than.
Seems like I learned it very much like this, and I want to unlearn it.
For you to unlearn that, you will be seriously and kindly within yourself growing up. You would be as dearness within yourself, no longer accepting your confinement to yourself. You'd be taking complete responsibility for the kind of self you have. You would begin to make choices in your heart. Choices that are bigger than the self you have.
That I'm bigger than the self I have.
You'll be making choices. Choices that are larger than the kind of self you have. That puts yourself into perspective of what you're capable. So far, yourself is in perspective of your experience of it. And you're in that experience all of the time.
Yeah, it is since I moved in this flat. It's really strange.
For you to be more than what yourself is, you need to be that within that just precedes yourself. Your heart comes before yourself. For you to live in your heart in a way that isn't patterned by the kind of self you have is for you to be larger than yourself. For you to soften in your heart in the midst of your patterned self, in the midst of your experience of yourself, as you being within what is more than what yourself is, softening in your heart in the midst of your patterned self, as you being different than what yourself is. In your experience of yourself, according to your patterned self, you would not be softening in the midst of your experiences. In the midst of your experiences, you would be tightening and hardening. You contract within. In contracting within, you make yourself to be bigger than you. As soon as you are softening within, in the midst of yourself, then you are bigger than what yourself is. As awareness, relate to openness and softness of heart instead of relating to yourself. Openness and softness of heart is like you. Whereas yourself isn't like you. Even though you relate to yourself as being like you. You do really like openness and softness of heart. You deeply like it. You love openness and softness of heart. The reason that you love it, the reason that you like it, is because it is like you. It is like you deep within. And the reason that you don't really like yourself, it's because yourself isn't really like you. Yet you keep relating to it. As long as you're relating to yourself, you won't be able to move past yourself. As long as you're relating to yourself, you're believing yourself. You're taking yourself seriously. When you take openness and softness of heart seriously, you're deeply moved within. When you take openness and softness of heart seriously, You are in that moment grounded within, in what is deeper than what yourself is. As soon as you're relating to openness and softness of heart, you are relieved of the kind of self you have. You're relieved of it because you're being what is bigger than what yourself is. As soon as you are opening and softening within, your heart is more than what yourself is. Yourself being less than what your heart is enables yourself to change without the focus of yourself being you're trying to change it. Your focus within is openness and softness of heart. That lets yourself change. As soon as you are as awareness, opening and softening within, and you see yourself, you know that you're responsible for yourself. The self you have is the self that is yours. When you're opening and softening within, in the midst of yourself, you know that you are able within yourself to be growing up, to not be pushed and pulled by the kind of self you have. When you have openness and softness of heart within, in the midst of the kind of self you have, you will also have a greater measure of clarity of mind. Openness and softness of heart in the midst of yourself frees your mind. As soon as you're not relating to yourself, you have freer thinking in how you see yourself. As long as you're relating to yourself, your thinking is bound to suit yourself.
It's all about the self, you mean?
You'll think in a way that makes yourself comfortable. You make yourself comfortable with the kind of self you have. You falsely accept yourself for what it is. As soon as you're opening and softening within, your thinking concerning yourself becomes free. Then you'll be able to accept yourself for what it is, but no longer falsely so, but truly so.
That is that I have an objective look at it and not a subject like I...
The openness and softness of heart gives you genuine objectivity concerning yourself. The openness and softness of heart in the midst of yourself also makes you as awareness more delicate than what yourself is. You'll be as awareness deeply feeling, delicately feeling what you know the truth of in your heart, without your being emotionally drawn in to the kind of self you have. You're accustomed to being ruled and governed by the emotional ground in yourself. instead of your being governed by what you know the truth of in your heart, and then feeling that isn't going to suit yourself. Feeling what you know the truth of in your heart will have you as awareness growing up in yourself. You'll be accepting yourself for what it is. But you'll be accepting yourself as something that you're no longer governed by. Yourself is what you have. The self that you have isn't what governs your beingness. And its patterned ways isn't what governs what you do. All of that comes from what is just deeper within than what yourself is. What governs what you're being, and what governs what you're doing within yourself, doesn't come from yourself. It comes from what you know the truth of in your heart. The first that you know the truth of in your heart doesn't have anything to do with doing. It has to do with beingness. The beingness that you first know the truth of in your heart is that of openness and softness. Relate to what you know within, instead of relating to the self you have. You will still have real difficulties in yourself. This won't change the level of your difficulty. It will change what your difficulty is. Instead of your difficulty being entrapment to yourself, your difficulty will be that of growing up within yourself. Holding to what you know the truth of within, holding to it by opening and softening to it in the midst of a patterned self that doesn't favor that. What you favor in yourself is to contract, to tighten, and to harden, and to manifest that through your emotions and through your will, either through aggression or through being a victim.
Yeah, I have a sense it is the old, just what I did in childhood, and I don't want it anymore, so...
But it suits yourself. What you're not wanting to have anymore suits yourself. It suits yourself for you to have aggression, and it suits yourself for you to be a victim. As long as you're relating to yourself emotionally, as long as you're believing yourself, you will need the use of yourself. You will need being a victim and having aggression. It is how you cope with the kind of self you have. You cope with yourself by being what yourself is. Instead of being what yourself is, be what you know you are, deeper within than what yourself is. What you really are, deeper within, is openness and softness. For you to be seriously relating to that, seriously believing you instead of yourself, your difficulties will change. Your difficulties will not lessen. they will just change. You'll have all of the difficulties of being responsible for the kind of self you have. You'll have all of the difficulties of growing up within. You'll have all of the difficulties of no longer being governed emotionally and through your will of the kind of self you have. The difficulties within of being openness and softness in the midst of a self that isn't like that. Enabling yourself to change, but not without much difficulty. If you're looking to escape difficulty, you won't find it. The escape of difficulty doesn't exist. For you to escape difficulty in the immediate, you'll experience it in the next moment. It comes back to you in the self that you wouldn't be real and true within, making your patterned self stronger than before, presenting you with greater difficulty. For you to open and soften within, in the midst of yourself, as it is, your difficulties are immediate. You'll face the difficulty of the emotional pull within yourself. For you to identify with yourself, to relate to yourself, to believe yourself. It will cost you as awareness to remain open and soft in your heart, in the midst of yourself that isn't like that. Being true to what you know within will change for you what is easy. It will change for you what is difficult. What you're accustomed to of ease is giving into yourself. It's easy for you to believe your emotions, to believe the truth of your emotions. Your emotions all have to do with your patterned self. When you open and soften within, in the midst of that patterned self, you'll find immediately an ease of being. Your ease will not be that of relating to yourself. Your ease will be that of relating to openness and softness within. Your ease will change, as will your difficulties.
There is an ease in me, and I don't know if it is openness and softness. It is as if I leave easiness.
You have both ease and difficulty in yourself. The ease doesn't belong to yourself. The ease that you give to yourself belongs to your being. When you give that ease to your being, you will have an ease of being in the midst of your difficult self. You will still have difficulty in yourself because you're responsible for yourself. The forms and the structures of yourself are imperfect. Because they're imperfect, you will necessarily have difficulty in yourself. You will necessarily need to develop and to evolve yourself. All of that implies difficulty. You don't need to have any difficulty of being. The difficulty belongs in yourself. The ease belongs in your being. Don't give the ease to yourself anymore. When you give the ease that belongs to your being, to yourself, you're surrendering to yourself. You're surrendering to what you're feeling in yourself. You're surrendering to relating to yourself. You're surrendering to believing yourself. Yourself doesn't represent the truth in you. Your being does. Give your ease only to what you know represents the truth in you. When you remove that ease that you give to yourself and you give it back to your being, difficulty in yourself remains. But that difficulty will be different. Instead of the difficulties being your consequences to surrender to yourself, the difficulties will be that you're now growing up in yourself. You're moving past yourself. You're taking responsibility for yourself. And no longer being governed by the kind of self you have. You will be like a parent to yourself. Yourself being more like a child. You won't be governed by that child anymore. You'll be raising that child. As a being, you'll be more than what yourself is. You'll be responsible for yourself. Yourself will change by your being bigger than what yourself is. As soon as you have openness and softness of heart in the midst of your patterned self, your heart is bigger than yourself. Live that way.
Is it then I experience that my attention goes very quick in the self? And when you say, I am the ease in the being, then the attention can a little more rest and it's not freaking out in the self anymore so much. Yes? So that is the balance maker a little bit, yeah? Okay.
As soon as you give the ease, no longer to yourself, but to your being, you will not freak out in yourself anymore.
That sounds good. I don't believe it yet. The ease already went into the self. So the help I wanted was to ground myself better.
Yourself will be grounded as soon as you don't believe it anymore.
I don't want the self to ground, but the whole self to ground. Yeah, so it...
Give all of your ease to your being, and your whole self will be grounded. It'll be grounded in what you are as a being, instead of yourself being grounded in your surrender to yourself.
It is so strange why I did it the wrong way, why I learned it something. So, thank you.
The ways of yourself are not the same as the ways of your being. You need to believe and relate to the ways of your being, instead of believing and relating to the ways of yourself. if a parent were to relate to, directly relate to, and directly believe the ways of a child, that child will rule the entire house.
I don't understand.
That would make the child master in the house.
If the parent would be serious to the real in the child?
If the parent would be serious to the ways of the child, that would make the child master in the house. The child will rule everyone. It will turn into a sick house. If the parent rules by what it knows within, the house will be a house of healing. The parent will then be ruling by what it knows within. The parent will rule as a being over its own self and be the same way to the child, giving the ease to the child, to its being, instead of giving the ease to itself. The ease belongs to its being, within the parent and within the child. Give the ease to yourself, and you will freak out in yourself. Give the ease to your being, and you will not freak out in yourself, because yourself won't be in control anymore. Your beingness will be in control within the kind of self you have. As soon as openness and softness of heart does by you rule within all of yourself, you'll be realizing the depth of womanness. You won't be a childish woman anymore.
I keep thinking about openness and softness. When you talk about ease, then I can better relate to. I understand ease. And when you say openness and softness, then I have to think, what? Is it something different?
When the patterns in yourself, through your experience of emotion and will, go like this, then you, as awareness within your heart in that moment, in the midst of that, go like this. Like giving the ease to the openness, instead of giving the ease to the tightness. Whatever you give the ease to grows. At the end of your day, have a little book. Call it the Book of Ease. And write down in that book at the end of the day, according to your memory, what you were giving your ease to throughout the day. And you'll see. You'll begin to understand what's happening in yourself why yourself is the way it is. You'll see what happens to yourself when you give your ease to your being instead of giving your ease to yourself. Do this every day, and you will love learning by your own book.
You once said to me, we spoke about the relation that we have, and then you, after that you spoke, this is your pillow, like sleeping on it, and it doesn't work, and maybe because I don't open and soften.
When you lay your head on your pillow, relate to the pillow as belonging to your being instead of the pillow belonging to yourself. The comfort of the pillow doesn't belong to yourself. It belongs to your being. Give your comfort to your being instead of to yourself, and yourself will rest. When you give your comforts to yourself won't be able to rest.